photoaging is quite a complex question to address. Most doctors, dermatologists, and patients think that sun is the only factor. This is not entirely true. If you think about it, sun is the major exposure from our environment to take us to photoaging, but it's not the only one. So when I speak about photoaging, you need to control other things in your life as well. How much you sleep, what you eat, where do you live, what kind of pollutant you're exposed to, what is the stress level in your life, and other factors like that. And also smoking is a major component of photoaging. But if you talk about the photoaging part, still UV protection by sunscreens and clothing is the single most important thing that you can do for the health of your skin and the long-lasting youth of your skin. But when we talk about recommendations, you always ask where this recommendation comes from. And there is a clinical trial, a study conducted in Australia in 2013, when a large number of patients, nearly 1,000 volunteers, have been using sunscreen either on a daily basis, on a meticulous daily basis, or on an occasional level. And it turns out that those who kept using the sunscreens for more than 4 years looked much younger on the longer run than those who were just using sunscreens on a need-to-use basis. So the message is quite clear. If you use sunscreens on a regular basis, daily, that will give you the desired effect of long-lasting, less photo-damaged skin. What is relatively new in this field is that UV, especially UVB and UVA, has a long history of understanding how it leads to photoaging. What is new is that there's an increasing number of evidence showing that infrared and visible light has also an importance. When you talk about it, several articles have been done research on exposing UVA1, which is very close to the visible light, and also another article was citing data when just infrared light was exposed to the skin, and these changes can induce very specific changes in matrix metalloproteinase expression level, which is the biochemical effector mechanism of photoaging. So now we know that it's not only the UV, not only the UVA that makes the damage. It's still the single most important part, but other than that, you have to be careful about infrared and visible light, especially blue light exposure to your skin. There's a fundamental research going on, understanding of other non-UV factors of this. This is like the role of nitrogen dioxide, which is part of the pollutants, smoking, other components of tobacco smoke that can lead us to photoaging, mitochondrial DNA damage, which is also important basic effector mechanism of photoaging. So basically, I think the future is going to be products where you have a complete UVA, UVB, and partial visible light protection, and also a combination of antioxidants and other molecules, future molecules, that are able to alleviate the damage that all these environmental factors can cause to our skin.